Anyone invites who wants to be suspended or adjacent to these meetings? Thank you. May be seated.
Kimuelang iyo lang, dato paktaya lang ang day iman na nufaka ng tapaw lang. Ano lewo ka, initan umay lang kung sa. Taytay naman ito, sulfuwa, masiyola. Tatutin mo rin mawin na ito sa Nino, Natali. Natali, iya, and Mickey, Junior, Pulituwa. Ule ama ito, ipafilo ay ituway. Inumbago daw fiyo, ufayo na Tova amay ngay. Tamama tinama atuwa, papel fara uiti. Efakutor ma ito, ipafilo ay nato, wile amay itara din. A Yesu Kristo la po yawaso na tara. Tau na yai na mamo leli. Au tatu yai. I'd like to welcome everyone, greetings to members of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, to families of Meki Julia Pulitua, and to all his friends. A special welcome and greeting to all the carers, nurses, and all MJ's friends. Ote fasi sila tunay tiba. Kondisi niyo ba ay ngay? Ito'y pamanatwa tumuntak sa mga. Pangumori ito si siya ay mamamu ni sa mga. Ina yung fayo matapiyan nila ang telefon. Pay pa silence. Ina yung tao siya ay mamamu ni sa mga. In the starting of this funeral service, presiding over this service is President Manoso, our state president, Andrew Manoso. He has asked me to conduct Bishop Donald Baibea, and sitting up here with us as well is my counselor, first counselor in the bishopric, his brother Stiles. We will start this service with an opening hymn. Found on page 126, 126 in Samoa. They are fighting Italia. After which, may I also invite Sister Phil, who is the first counselor of the primary presidency, to open this meeting with a prayer.
Oh, to la ta ya o ma to ke fi la ra ma to te pa fo ya to ni o ma pa te te la ra o fi o na o fa ya na o fa ma to to mai ne ne o fi ya i a i ma fo i a i ma te le o o ma ya sa ni a i ma se la ra o su ma ma to te ta i o ma to te ma la ni ma to pa te te la ra i le ku ku na ra o fi ya te ma te I want to know what to feel like for him and he has a heat for him. If I feel like I want to know just a little bit of a massive gift here, I want to know. No matter to my life, I need a way to be. I want to take stand on what I will feel. If I feel like I want to smell it, I want to feel it, it matters. I am a good thing, I want to put it. I want to take that in. Yeah. I'm so strong.
He was fighting with his diagnosis, our family and our strength. He was so strong, he was such a strong boy, right? And just going home after 1 year of hospital with him, it was a lot, you know, a lot to learn. New things we had to learn, you know, how to give medication. You know, I had to learn how to do his dialysis every night for him. And just all his cares. Every month, he would end up in hospital admission because he's so new. He's easily to get sick, so in hospital every month for 6 weeks. And every week, we would take him for his hospital appointments, just get him checked. He was a fighter. And it was very hard, it was stressful. But I know that, and I always remember this quote on my head, that if you put your trust in God, you know, He will lead you and guide you anything you're going through. And that's what got us here, that's what got me here. He literally, you know, showed me how to be a strong mom. We learned a lot from my son, you know. We learned how to have patience. We have to have faith. And we have to keep going. He was very sick, my son. But he always smiles. Always smiles. Just the same as he was born. The only time you know when MJ is not okay is when he's not smiling. That's when you know something's wrong with MJ. He's not feeling okay. It's been a hard couple of years, you know, 3 years. And just this last admission, he left us with New Year's Day. And he never came back home until now, his final days. And I'm very grateful for this gospel that we're in, because I know that if it wasn't the gospel, if it wasn't our faith, we wouldn't be here, standing here. We don't know what happened to our family, the situation, our relationship with my husband. So I'm very grateful and blessed. I'm grateful as well and thankful to all the hospital staff, all his treating team, the doctors, his ward Clancy. MJ makes you run around, you know, but that's how he is, you know. He's very complex, so it was very hard for the doctors to, you know, to figure out what he needs because it's just very complex. And I'm grateful for all of you, my son's care team, for all your care that you provided for MJ, your patience, and your love and support to our family. To all these carers, I am grateful for all of you that help us care for our son when he was at home. We wouldn't be able to care when it wasn't for your help. I know how much you all love MJ. And I see you today. And I'm grateful to all our state, very good state members, for all your prayers, love and support for our family, especially our son. I know that all your prayers got us through to today. I'm grateful for all the leaders, our President Manuso, his counselors, Bishop Ayono, Bishop Thomas, counselors, everyone, you know, for showing us love. Visited our son in the hospital. Thank you. And to all our families and friends, near and far, here today, thank you for all the love that you have shown and supported us. And to Diana as well for being here from the beginning to now. To our girls, his sisters, MJ's sisters, for being so strong and patient, going his death will always be a positive one. Every time we have meetings in the hospital, and that's the hardest thing, going through these last 3 years with my son, was always having meetings every week, almost a couple of days. It was hard, you know, sitting around the room, all the doctors around, trying to figure out what MJ needs, what to do to help him. I will always cry, I'm always so emotional, because that's my son, and my mother. And there's his dad sitting there, you know, so positive, making jokes. That's how he's always been, looking, making jokes. Just to keep me strong, just to keep me going. But I know inside, he's hurt, but he doesn't show it. MJ, we call you Tamatoa because you're such a brave boy. You're a Tamatoa. You're strong, you're a fighter. You have fought for 3 years. You have fought for what was right, for justice for you, for your family. And you have been a blessing in our family, son. I know that Heavenly Father sent you here for a mission, because since he's been through this in hospital, he has saved a lot of babies, a lot of children's lives, this time and in the future because of what happened to my son. He has helped so many lives in the hospital and the people that he got to know and love. He has helped us so much as well. You know that your mama will never let you go. You're my mama's boy. You're my sunshine. I love you and miss you so much, son. Fly high, my baby. Till we meet again. I'm grateful for this gospel that, and I don't believe that families can be together forever. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Thank you so much for everything, especially doctors and nurses you here together with them, Chase family, friends, families. Whenever you look at me, my handsome face now, thank you so much for everything you do, prayer. What I tell you, it's a pretty much the only way. He's really listened to me. And when I saw him, another Sunday, my wife said, can you swap our sheets? You can all MJ down to the tonight. But okay, why not? MJ know me, my dad's here. Especially every Sunday, we always just play these primary songs. And MJ's moves and knows that. No Coco Mel, no Miss Rachel. Say goodbye your, I don't know, your friend or your girlfriend Miss Rachel. Sunday, primary song. Only one day you have a, there's a holy Sunday. And I was inside his rule and serve him. Come on, Jen. Let's go, Jen. And I saw, look at me. Hopefully you're happy. And I enter your room, son. And I play the skip, no popo man, and I play the music, gospel, primary song. And I saw him, he forced to listen. He doesn't like, he wanna echo go man. It was my mom, I said, don't worry, man. Even your energy are silent. You're not a boss, I'm your boss. And he said to me, oh, I love you, son, he gave me a smile. Every one time, I 5 to 6 hours, and I was in his room, and he said, his mom have raised already, spoke. When I just hear mom's voice, and Jay, how are you, my sunshine? And Jay's like, he need to change the channel to Coco Man. Because he forced himself, because his dad is boss beside him. They, okay, man. You can listen to your mom. I love like this song. If they buy more rumor and they buy Thank you so much for everything. Your prayer, your love, you drop the food in front of our house. Oh, God bless you. But they did it. They have a little to you in Mango Center. Talk to yourself. Yeah, what do I need out of the way? Yeah, listen. Only if we talk to you, you're sweet. Thank you so much. But they did it. Now we told them we're not sweet. The board of course is back here, but who is made by? But they did it. Now we told them we're late. Now we told my girlfriend we're pretty good for him. Are you open? My son? Well, my dad's son. And we are the nation of tomorrow. We live on the house of tomorrow. Yeah. After all, we need to show that I am on tomorrow. And by all my father's hope, to fulfill it, I am. But they tell me about tomorrow. Dan ini itu long to about tahu. Ini oh my god ini my no way to stop. Cuma gue fat ben ini follow to for you and take to on that and go make it see the two on that. Then we tell us that I am the dia ta to find the person. Malu malu lah ten ni polis ta ilawa. Si dia in law ni si lawa. Tapi dia ni nak semua data ini ni bae macam ni. Ilang itu mak ayam ni dia so ayam aku, ya tu bosi lah mai mui tu ifar ni lah, ya dia fanya itu mak ayam dia tu, tu orang kan dia faru dia bulma, istimewa dia pen tu dia nak bulma aku istimewa job saja lah, something happy dah orang, ni mana dia ni siapa yang kita ayam so hati, ya kios. Don't worry. Now I'm going to say, he's an angel. You never know, maybe tomorrow got another brother. You never know. You never know. Yeah, but we're taking the Shalima, Levi, Oyasu. Yeah, but I'm not for Shalim. But I tell you, when I talk about that, I make my mistake when it's important. And Koko will be my mother. La parola fu io dei lo poi è luo tanto pazzia dei ma visto poi come lo vuole fare via e ahi fa mia la tua mamma tanto stecchi a tu tanto lo poi e ai maci lo lo langi a tu e lo vuoi a ieri avuto fa pesa tempo a lani e ai te le qua 예배로 나도 이 스포크 예수께 비소 아멘.
Thank you, Brother and Sister Palatua, for wonderful testimony that was born. Memories. One of my favorite movies was Upo. And as Upo is a storyteller, and he loved telling the story of his father, loved telling the story of how he becomes king. One of the quotes says, memories is the most powerful magic of all. When he plays his guitar, all the papers fall from it and start making a lot of story artifacts. bonato we tawe upulea mafetu ulong swa ono yesu kiriso e ma fai o tatu bona fatasi ma tu. One of the greatest blessings of being a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints is to get to understand the wonderful plan that was placed for. It's called the plan of happiness, the plan of Heavenly Father, the plan of salvation. That answer the questions of the soul. These questions will never come in daily conversation. But these are the times and moments where these questions arise. The questions of where we came from, why are we here, and where do we go after we die? As you accept the Savior's atonement, through faith in Him, repentance, baptism, and receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost, you will come to understand this wonderful plan. And this plan gives us hope. Hope for a better life. Hope that one day we will see each other again and reunite with our families and loved ones. Because of Jesus Christ, we can live again. The answer lies in two great, insurmountable challenges that every one of us face. First, we all die. Yes, we do. No matter how young, beautiful, healthy, or cautious you are, someday your body will become lifeless. Friends and families will mourn you, but they cannot bring you back. Nevertheless, because Jesus Christ, your death will be temporary, not permanent. Your spirit one day will reunite with your body. The resurrected body will not be subject to death anymore. You will live in eternity, free from pain, physical suffering. This will happen because of Jesus the Christ, who laid down his life and took it up again. He did this even for those who walk. He did this for all who believe in him. He did this for all who do not believe in him. He even did this for those who walk, revile, curse his name. Because of Jesus Christ, we can live with God. Second, we all sin. This life we live, our sins will forever keep us from living with God. Because no unclean things can enter his kingdom and be with our loved ones again. As a result, every man, woman, and child was shut out of his presence. This is until Jesus Christ, the Lamb without spot, offered his life as a ransom of our sins. Because Jesus owed no debt to justice, he could pay our debt and meet the demands of justice for every single soul. And that includes you and me. Jesus Christ paid the price for our sin. All of them. And that most important day in history, Jesus Christ, or Jesus the Christ, opened the gates of death and cast aside the barriers that prevented us from passing into the holy and hallowed halls of everlasting life. Because of our Lord and Savior, you and I are granted a most precious and priceless gift, regardless of our past. We can repent and follow the path that leads to celestial light and glory, surrounded by the faithful children of our Heavenly Father. I am forever grateful to our Savior Jesus Christ. My personal testimony of him. I know he lives. He is my Savior, Redeemer, and a friend. I follow counsel of a loving Father in the Book of Mormon, whom Sister Paulette quoted. Whoever shall put his trust in him, Jesus Christ, will be supported in your trials and tribulations, and will help you. I know he loves each and every one of us, and he knows our struggles. I know he knows MJ more than our struggles. I invite you all to take a minute and to reflect upon our Savior Jesus Christ and come to his knowledge, because he has opened his arms wide and invited all of us. Say to come, all ye that are labor and are heavy laden, for I shall give you rest. He is the only begotten of the Father. And because Heavenly Father loves us, he has sent his only begotten Son to save us all. It is my testimony. In the sacred name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Followed by his remarks, we will close this service, our funeral service. And the song found in page 89, Psalm 1 book. After which, my first counsel of Brother Stiles will conclude his service with a prayer. I'd like to thank all that participate and came to witness his last service for our dear friend, son, Chen Tamato, Mickey Jr. Ulitu. Ore sa lo fa i ko le a sa lo ya i ku fa ma lo sa mi ko. Pristen ne en tu mo so. A mai a sa lo ma pristen. Na ta ku na ki na le o di ma fa i lo mo ri tu na lo ba na su mo le ba. Ma ta sa na tu le so so ni mo bua na pa ta stars. Na te fa ni na le sa mi ma se ta. Mori atu te nama whakutai tele i wō mai mai nga tōu na sū mai mā whio mai. Tātou mori ma uina i toi sau hima, pre atari. Ia meki tūnia pui tua. Tāu e iei whakamianga te maore nana. Ia masinga ma toi sau hima o toi, o le leias. President Manoza.
Thank you, Bishop. Family and friends, I want to thank you for being here this morning. We're here to show love and respect to the Pulitoa family and mother and father and daughters, and pay our respects to a young man who had an effect on many of our lives. Some of us knew him intimately, some of us knew the family. But over the last 3 years, I've got to know Brother and Sister Pulitoa, and thank you for your faith. I've got to know Mickey and the girls, and Mickey has made me a better person. I remember the first time I went to visit with him was to give him a blessing, and I met with the family and asked them, you know, if they had faith in Jesus Christ. And throughout that blessing and many other blessings that I think he's received, is because of his faith that he lived for those 3 years. And his mission was to bless our lives. That is why he came here. He made us better people. On behalf of the family, I want to thank those medical professionals, those carers, those who cared for him and loved him. You exemplified what the Savior has asked us to do, which is to love one another. And it's because of that love you've shown, we don't get an opportunity to say thank you to you very often. You're usually running around frantic, but we want to express that love and appreciation to you. We come from all different faiths. The one thing that unites us all is that we are all sons and daughters of God. We are all given that opportunity to care for those in need, to stand by our family, our friends, even strangers, to express our love and just help them in any way. And by you being here today, you've done that to the Pulitoa family. They have felt your love, and I have felt your love as well. Well, Mickey, he was a wonderful young boy and taken very soon from us. But we will have and share those memories about him for many years to come. Each of you had that special moment with him. Maybe it was a quiet moment or a memory throughout your time, but please cherish that and remember it. How did he make you a better person? For those who aren't members of our faith and may not understand Psalm 1, we just sang a hymn for families can be together forever. And the words of that hymn is, I have a family here on earth. They are so good to me. I want to share my life with them through all eternity. The second verse says, while I am in my early years, I will prepare most carefully so I can marry in God's temple for eternity. Families can be together forever through Heavenly Father's plan. I always want to be with my own family, and the Lord has shown me how I can. The Lord has shown me how I can. We can be united as eternal families, and that is a doctrine that is unique to the gospel of Jesus Christ. As Bishop so wonderfully explained, explaining the great plan of salvation, where we came from, why we're here, and where we go after this life. And through times like this, it is very difficult to understand that plan of salvation. It's very hard. Our hearts are burdened. Our hearts are heavy. But Jesus Christ knew that we would have to go through this, and we would suffer pains and afflictions of every kind. And before he left his apostles, he said to them, "But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, and the Father shall send in my name, shall teach you all things and bring all things to remembrance." Now, many of us don't understand what the 12 family are going through, but it is the Comforter that has given them the strength to be able to continue on. It's the Comforter that gives us the strength to get through the many difficult things that we face. I'm grateful for the Holy Ghost. I'm grateful that it is a Comforter. It gives me strength. It teaches me all things. In the Book of Mormon, another testament of Jesus Christ, Mormon, who is the author of the book, says this about those who have passed on that are young children. And as he ponders on his message, he prays about the state of those souls that have passed beyond, especially those who are young. And he says this in the Book of Mormon. He says, "Listen to the words of Christ, your Redeemer, your Lord and your God." And this is what he says: "Behold, I come unto the world, not to call the righteous, to sinners to repent. The whole need no physicians, but those that are sick. Wherefore, children are made whole, for they are not capable of committing sin. Wherefore, the curse of Adam is taken from them. You have no power over them." Brothers and sisters, the doctrine is taught that all young children are made perfect in and through the atonement of Jesus Christ. They will return to the presence of Heavenly Father as perfect beings. And as we now wait for our turn to be able to return to our Father, we have been met and greeted by many. I look forward to that day. I look forward to the day that we can meet with him and embrace him. That he will tell us the wonderful stories and the times that we share with him. I bear testimony that this will happen, that it is true. That regardless of who we are or what faith we are all sons of God. We will all return to his presence. And we will all be living out this life. I bear testimony that we express our love and appreciation to the Kulitua family for the faith that you have and the strength that you want to each of us. And I leave your blessings in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Katrina.
Thank you.
Thank you.